Hello everyone. In this session, we will discuss about the continuous control system. The continuous control system's main objective is to maintain the values of the output variable at a desired level. Especially in the continuous control system, normally the control system what it is adopted is nothing but a feedback control system. However, most of the continuous process is practical in practical world consists of the separate feedback loops, all which have to be monitored, controlled and coordinated to maintain the exact output, or it may be a fixed output at the desired value. If not, means it is very difficult to maintain the continuous control system. The several ways to achieve the control objectives in a continuous process control systems are: the continuous control systems usually objective is to maintain the value of the output variable at a desired level. The parameters and as well as the various variables should be continuously monitored. The similar to the operation of the feedback control system, most of the continuous industrial process have multiple feedback control loops. Example, the control of the output of a chemical reaction that depends upon the so many parameters. Example, either it may be temperature, or it may be a pressure, or even it may be the catalyst what they are adding it. And the control and the position of the cutting tool relative to the work piece or the work part in the CNC machine tool are some of the examples with respect to the continuous process control systems. The types of the control systems, or it may be a continuous process control systems, are regulatory control systems, feed forward control systems, steady state control systems, adaptive control systems, online search strategies, other specialized techniques like expert systems and as well as the neural networks. The first one, regulatory control systems. In the regulatory control system, the main objective is to maintain the process performance at a certain level within a given tolerance band. This is appropriate for examples when the performance attributes is some measurable and the of the product quantity. This is important to keep the quality at a specified level within a specified range. In many of the applications, the performance and the measure of the process, sometimes called as the index performance, most of them are calculated based on the several output variables and as well as the process. The experts for this features regulatory controls is to the overall the process what feedback control is to an individual control loop in the process as suggested. The trouble with the regulatory control system is that compensating action is taken only after the disturbance has affected the process output. The following control mode or the feed forward control system is address this issue. The schematic diagram shows the regulatory control system. Feed forward control system. The main objective of the feed forward control system is to anticipate the effect of the disturbance that will upset the process by sensing the compensating that it has to be made before affecting the process. The mathematical models captures the effect of the disturbance on the process. The complete comprehension, or it may be compensation, for the disturbance is difficult due to the variations, imperfections and mathematical models and imperfections in the control actions. Usually the combined and as with the regulatory control systems, the regulatory control systems and a feed forward control systems are more closely associated with the process industries. This is a schematic diagram or the block diagram which is representing with respect to the feed forward control systems. Now the steady state control system. Steady state control system is also something like an open loop. The class of the optimization technique in which the process exhibits the following characteristics: a well-defined index performance and known relationship between the process variable and as well as the input variables and the system parameters for optimization. The input can be determined mathematically. The open loop system optimizes technique includes the differential calculus and as well as the mathematical programming. The schematic diagram shows the feed forward control combined with the feedback control systems. Now the steady state now adaptive control system. Because of the steady state optimization in an open loop, it cannot be compensated for the disturbance. Adaptive control systems is self-correcting for the optimal control that includes the feedback control system measure that relevant process variable during the operation that is controlled by means of a feedback control system. By using a controlled algorithm that attempts to optimize some index performances, the adaptive control operates a time varying environment. The environment changes over the time and as well as the changes, then the potential effects on the system performance is also a major factor. Example, supersonic aircraft operates differently in the subsonic flights than in the supersonic flights. If the control or algorithm is fixed, the system may perform quite differently in one environment than in other. An adaptive control system is designed to compensate for the change in environment by altering some aspects its control algorithm and achieving the optimal performance. The schematic diagram shows the adaptive control system. In this, the modification, decision, and as well as the identification is another parameter which is to be adapted in the process. Now, online search strategies. The online search strategies can be used to address a special class of adaptive control systems in which the decision functions cannot be sufficiently defined. The relationship between the input parameter and the index of the performance is not known and not known well enough to use the adaptive control previously described. Therefore, it is not possible to decide on the change in the internal parameters of the system to produce a desired performance improvement. Based on the results of these experiments, a large change are made in the input parameters to drive the process towards the improved performance. Online search strategies includes a variety of the schemes that explores the effect of the change in the process parameters and the ranging by means of a trial and error techniques. Now, discrete control system. Discrete control systems are the control systems where the parameters and variables of the system are changed at a discrete moment in time. The change involves the variables, the parameters, and also the discrete typically by a means of on and off. The changes are defined in advance by means of the program instructions. For example, the work cycle programs. The changes normally executed either because of the state of the system or the because of the certain amount of the time has elapsed. There are two cases of the discrete control systems are event-driven change and as well as a time-driven change. The event-driven change is executed by the controller in response to some event caused by the state of the system to be altered. The change can be initiated by an operation terminating an operation and to start with another operation. Or the robot loading the work part and into a fixture, and the part is sensed by the limit switch and a fixture. The time driven changes the executes by the control system either by a specific point in time or after a certain point of time. As before, the change usually consists of the starting something or stopping something, and the time when it changes occurs the important. In factories, normally the stop clock sounds as the bell. Specific time indicates the start of the shift and as well as the break starts and as well as the stop of the factory and as well as the end of the shift. This is automatically controlled and it's a time bound where the time driven changes can be executed very easily in this process. The two types of the changes normally corresponds to different types of discrete control systems. The first one is a logic control is used to the control to execute event driven the change. A sequential control is used to manage the time driven change. These type of control systems are discussed and expanded coverage in the discrete control systems is widely used in a discrete manufacturing and as well as the processing industries.